I never liked you, homie. I should hear your speech less.
You hear me, nigga?
I'm coming for the top. The bad boy, he never stops. I got a lot of time, and all you got is a watch. You need to give it up. You really don't have the stamina. I see you like to die, but you ain't up on my caliber. I swag step, and I'll always be ahead of you. To me, you still a lame, cause nobody's ever heard of you. I lean, I rock, I step with swag. I'm selling haters, now I've always got it in a bag. We hot.
You fly.
We first.
You last.
The interstate kings always stepping with a swag.
Hey.
I'm stepping with a swag. We don't really like to brag.
Right.
I'm stepping with a swagger that you haters never had.
Right.
I'm stepping with a swag.
We
don't really like to brag.
Right.
I'm stepping with a swagger that you haters never had.
Right.
I'm stepping with a swagger that you haters never had. On my high horse, so I brag. Stepping with a swagger, you haters don't even matter. I'm stepping with a swag. On my high horse, so I brag. Stepping with a swagger, you haters don't even matter. I step with swag. Yeah. My swag one and only. Make these women honey. Smoke so much reefer, my new nickname should be Stony. Combo with your wifey, afterwards she wanna bone me. So genuine, I gotta ride it on my pony. Drees bring the treason, has been the season. It got me on that track rapping like Snagglepuss even. Y'all some rap bastards, here's a bag of the cheeses. Grab your pistol, squeeze it, then go to court and plead it. I be on that fly shit, I be getting fresh now. Pigeon toes slagging when a nigga take a step now. Your wife be busted, she look good from the neck down. These women look at me and be like, bow chicken wow. I swag, I step, I swag. These Puerto Ricans call me Poppy like I was their dad. I swag, I step, I swag. I'm taking shots of Remy while I'm smoking on my bag.
I'm stepping with a swag, don't really like to brag. I'm stepping with a swagger that you haters never had. I'm stepping with a swag, don't really like to brag. I'm stepping with a swagger that you haters never had.
I step with swag. Yeah, they hate, but they broke them. And when it's time to pop, they had no show. Yeah, I'm pretty, but I'm loco. The loud got me moving slow-mo. Hey, yo, Tweety, where the hoes, bro? Hey, yo, Keys, where the hoes, though? That other nigga, he a bozo. It's a man,
you don't know.
We got liquor by the boatload. Disrespect the life, that's a no-no. All my niggas dressed in that Rojo. I ride for my guys,
that's the bro code.
Baby gave me head, that's a low blow.
And welcome back to the Dirk Stewart Show. Man, I don't know if she's the best or whatever they consider themselves. I don't know if they're the best or whatever, man. But this person, man, young M.A. or young Ma, whatever she calls herself or what they call themselves. I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm just confused on what to call her. But this person is, I mean, they got skill. Shouts out to Young Ma.
To the left of you. Like, we ain't in these streets more than sesame. But that's your chicken, why she texting me? Why she keep calling my phone, speaking sexually?
Yeah.
Every time I'm out, why she stressing me? You call her Stephanie?
Uh-huh.
I call her Heffany.
Hey.
I don't open doors for a whore. I just want them
That person got skills. I saw another video just the other day. Somebody posted a video, I guess one of her latest tracks on social media, man. I mean, that chick, that person can absolutely go. 404-382-0338. I'm getting thumbs to the side on whether that's appropriate to play Young Ma on Woman Wednesday. From Waterhead. Shut up, Waterhead. Shut up. That's not inappropriate. What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say? You're a woman. Stop saying that. He's laughing his ass off. Be quiet, Waterhead. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. Dirk Nowitzki joins the 30,000 point club. Ah, you talk about some of the cast that's in this thing, man. Kareem, Karl Malone, Michael Jordan, Wilt Chamberlain, and Kobe Bryant, man. All of these cats, man, in the 30,000 point club. Dirk Nowitzki now joins that club, one of only six NBA players in basketball history to do it. So not only do you have to be clearly a tremendous offensive player, but you got to have some luck. You got to have the ability to stay around and play basketball for 19 years, in which Dirk Nowitzki has done. And he's already said that he's planning to come back for a 20th season. And I think it's just him, and I don't have this stat in front of me, but I'm pretty sure, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, I think it's just him and Kobe, the only two on this list that played for one team. All right, obviously Kareem didn't play for one team. Kareem played for the Milwaukee Bucks. He played for the Lakers. Karl Malone played for the Lakers at the end of his career. Michael Jordan, you know, he did. He played for the Wizards and cats like that. And Wilt Chamberlain played for several teams. So, yeah, Kobe Bryant and Dirk Nowitzki are the only two on this list in the top six that played their entire careers with one team. And once again, Dirk has already said that he plans to come back for a 20th season. And so, man, incredible, incredible stat. And I've been asking the question, man. I'm looking in this chat room and trying to get your thoughts. Is Dirk the blueprint? Like, have you ever seen another player like Dirk and black or angry black man reminded me? Like, there's really not anybody like him today. And I guess there are a couple of guys like him today, but not to his level, okay? Not with success. And the main thing is hitting three-pointers. That's what kind of separates him, is hitting three-point shots. And so, man, this cat is just an incredible feat. I'm looking in the chat right now. Corey says, Doug, Magic was the blueprint for big guys handling the ball. That's a good one. I asked Stewie's to give me, like, a blueprint for, players that were the blueprint for whatever they did throughout their career. They brought something different to their prospective sports. And yeah, I don't think before Magic, and older cats can tell me that are listening right now, was anybody that handled the basketball that played point guard at 6'9". And I don't think so, because they always talk about Magic being, you know, this elite and the blueprint for a point guard. Several cats have came along after Magic Johnson that people thought were going to be the next Magic Johnson. You remember Walt Williams, they used to call him the Wizard. You remember Walt Williams? Walt Williams was supposed to be the next Magic Johnson, never really ended up being the next Magic Johnson. Walt Williams was a solid player. And where did he play college at? I think he played in Maryland. Walt Williams was a solid player in the NBA, but it never amounted to Magic Johnson. I mean, there ain't no more Magic Johnsons. At 6'9", that could handle the ball, was a phenomenal passer. Great floor leader. So there's been a lot of cats that have been tall. Sean Livingston is another cat. When he came out of high school, you know, like 6'9", 6'10", played point guard, I think, in high school. And they were talking about him being, you know, quasi one of the next Magic Johnson type players. Never really turned out to be that. And Sean Livingston's a good player. Remember, he had, like, injury issues. He tore his ACL or he broke his leg or something very early in his career. But Sean Livingston never amounted to Magic Johnson. Nobody amounted to Magic Johnson. So that's a good one. That's a good one as far as Magic Johnson being the blueprint for big point guards. And there's been a lot more, and I guess it's more accepted today. But there's nobody else that has kind of done what Magic has done. But, yeah, that's a very good one if you're talking about blueprints, the great Magic Johnson. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. from Rough Buff, Ciara is stepping for real. Is line stepping for real? We're going to talk about that later. I'm sure you've seen this picture of Russell Wilson, his wife Ciara, and their seven-year-old son. Buck naked. We'll get into that. From Barbershop Sports Talk Podcast, he says, damn it, Ninja, laugh out loud. Just congratulate the man on reaching 30,000 points. One of six players in history to do it. I hope one day Melo reaches that milestone. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Please don't tell me there's somebody in the chat room, in particular that Ninja, hating on Dirk Nowitzki today. Please don't tell me that. Whoa, let me go back in this chat and see if I can find. Here we go. That Ninja. Why do you speak about Nowitzki in such glowing terms, and every time you mention Carmelo Anthony, you speak about him like he's the worst damn thing to touch a basketball? Hey, bro, I shouldn't even dignify this with a response, but I'll just say this. Sir, I have never disparaged Carmelo Anthony. I think Carmelo Anthony is one of the greatest players that have ever played the game. He's just not a great team player, and he is a ball hog in a black hole. He is. Carmelo Anthony, and let me take a look at this, and if you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, let me pull up his stats real quick here. Carmelo Anthony, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Let me see how many points Carmelo Anthony has right now. Let me see if Carmelo Anthony is close to scoring 30,000 points for his career. Carmelo Anthony, for his career, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, and I can't find it right now. It don't even matter. Bottom line, Carmelo Anthony hasn't scored 30,000 points in his career. Get a man his due. Just get a man his due. And for people that don't know, Ninja has these very strange, freaky, kind of crazy little quirks about some people who he like and some people he don't like. Some athletes he likes and some athletes he don't like. So, yeah, you've never heard me rail on and on about Dirk Nowitzki before. Today is the day after he scored 30,000 points in the NBA, one of six people to do it. Boy, stop. From Brian Hill in the chat room, Fish, if Jacobs can consistently get away from that right. Shouts out to Jay Fish, the microwave, patty cake, microwave. When we were in the break just now, we played one of his melodies for the break music. From Gary G Money Joyner in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Woman, stop posting these naked photos with your son. The ish ain't cute. It's dirty to start with. Pedophilia. I'm trying to wait to get into that that Ciara Russell Williams or Russell Wilson photo a little bit later today on the entertainment segment. So we'll get to that. But one quick note, kind of like breaking news, former New York Jets wide receiver Brandon Marshall and New York Giants and the New York Giants have reached an agreement on a two-year deal worth $12 million. The Jets granted Marshall's wish and released the wide receiver, saving $7.5 million against his salary cap. Marshall and the Jets discussed the possibility of a return in 2017, but it didn't happen, and the Giants got him. The Giants got Brandon Marshall, who still got a lot left in the tank, I believe. That's a good-ass signing. That's a good deal. Yeah. That is a good deal. Already they got Odell Beckham Jr. They got they let Victor Cruz go. They got that Shepherd kid who balled out of control last year, Sterling Shepherd. And now you bring in Brandon Marshall. And you know me, I'm a New York sports hater, but that's a good signing. Like, I think Brandon Marshall got a lot left in the tank. His numbers dropped off last year, but I don't think that was so much because of him. I just think that the team sucked. And everybody tried to put in their quarterback sucked, including Ryan Fitzpatrick. So I think Brandon Marshall got a lot left in the tank. That's a real good signing for the New York Giants. Damn, good for y'all. They're starting it off. Yeah. So they start.